Die rolprent Felix het verlede week oopgemaak en Dagbreek kon ongelukkig nie by die premier wees nie, maar ons het gehoor dat dit baie goed gegaan het. Kom ons kyk gou eers die lokprent.
Get Mrs. Klaber on the line, please. Her son's application has been successful.
They want a wide berth, boys?
In every one of us lies a talent waiting to be shared.
Tell me, how was our boy's first day at school?
Very nice.
But while some wait for it to be discovered, others make it happen.
Thinking of auditioning. You know you need more than rhythm.
Hey. Hardly jazz.
This is the drum solo from Living Dead's Rigor Mortis Rock.
No. Stop. Are you reading, boy?
No, sir. I'm playing the Penny Whistle, sir.
Look, this is a classic jazz concert, not some hip-hop gig.
Is it Sifonya Gatata?
Yeah.
I think it's broken. I think you need lessons. But I can't just play. I have to read, Bracho. Read. For Tata's will.
We'll make him proud.
Namhlanje uzokhetha. Phakathi kwa or utata.
I don't want to be a musician no more.
Why not?
Because you end up dead.
Let's all be existentialists. Let's party.
We are the kings of the school, so don't mess with us, you fool. We cool.
Felix, we've got to get your sax back, man.
Ladies and gents, the Buzzer Boys!
This is the story of an ordinary boy with an extraordinary talent that changed every life it touched.
Mr. Impresario!
That's me, Hal.
Felix, in cinemas, 13 September.
Ons het met Layani Mabasa wat die naamrol vertolk genooi om met ons te kom gesels saam met Linda Sokulu wat die rol van sy ma Lindiwe vertolk. Good morning guys, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Linda, let's start with you. Felix is such a beautiful story. We've just seen the trailer and it looks so heartwarming. Please tell us about your character Lindiwe. Why does she not want Felix to play jazz?
Well, Felix's late father, used to be a jazz musician, a saxophonist, and unfortunately he overindulged in the lifestyle of jazz and stuff, and he ended up passing away as a result of overindulging in alcohol and then, you know, dying. And for those reasons, she's reluctant for her son, who is about to start this new life of going into this beautiful private school, and now he wants to play jazz, something that, you know, killed her husband.
Yeah.
Or not jazz killing her husband, but that he wants to go into that lifestyle. And that's something very scary for Lindy, and she's just like reluctant to see him going that route.
Layani, the character plays the penny whistle and the saxophone. Did you play jazz beforehand? Did you have a love for it beforehand? Or was it something you had to learn for the movie?
No, I liked jazz from the very beginning. Before I knew I was going to be shooting a movie that's involving jazz. But it was very, like, overwhelming for me, like, because I knew, they told me I was going to be playing the saxophone after I got the part. And I knew I had, like, it's a huge thing to play the saxophone. It's not just, like, you know. So what I did is I was very nervous, firstly. But I went there and they taught me how to play the saxophone and, yeah, I got it right.
If I've heard another interview with you, you actually didn't have that much time to learn the saxophone. You had like a month and then you actually had 3 days because of the shooting. Yeah, tell that story.
It was very hectic for me because I had school and I had like soccer practices and drama after that. So it was like all these things, like I had to like, you know, try manage my time very well.
Yeah.
So what I did is I had to like from school after like extra lessons and everything, I had to go to the place where I had to practice my saxophone and everything. And like I said, a saxophone is a very hard instrument to play, so it was not that easy. But in a week's time, I did kind of get it right. And then the penny whistle is very easy, so I nailed it in like one day. It was cool.
Is your dad a jazz musician as well? Or he plays jazz, or he loves jazz?
My dad loves jazz. He's like always bragging to me about how how it's good music and everything. My dad loves jazz, so I guess we've had that love for jazz together ever since like growing up and everything. Yeah,
so he must be, and your whole family must be very proud of you doing this film.
Yes, they're very proud of me. In fact, they even my friends are proud of me. Like everyone's proud of me, and my cousins too. So it's very cool knowing that people are actually like behind me and supporting me, knowing that this movie and everything.
Excellent. Cool. Linda, do you think this is a film with a message? Is it trying to make some kind of social commentary as well as just be a great feel-good movie?
I think so. The lovely thing about it is the way it's presented. Hlaini, who's just such a beautiful, bright-eyed young man, he plays that part so beautifully. And for me, all people who are coming of age will identify with it because it's someone's quest to, you know, find their voice and find their place under the sun. So from that perspective, it's great for young kids to go and watch, just to give them that, you know, gumption to say, yeah, I want to try something. I'm worth trying something. And then from a mother's perspective, it's, or a parent's perspective, it's more of a story of allowing your children to become who they are. So it's so beautifully crafted within the script, and I think that for those reasons, the people can identify with it, and it's fresh. It's light.
Yeah. Let's talk about the script. It's by Shirley Johnston, and it's based on a book as well. Or is it her original
script? It's her original script.
It's her original script. And how did you, as an actor, and you as well, Tlayani, how did you get to work with the text, and what did you enjoy about the script when you first read it?
How did you go first?
How polite.
Well, I actually fell in love with the audition pieces that I looked at. You know, just those few handful of scripts were just so real to me and so original, because there was, say, for example, one of them when Lindwe finds out that Felix is going to go and play, to go and win the saxophone back with his father's saxophone, and she sees the pamphlet, and the frustration that she has in that instance, and the truth that she, I mean, like, it's all encapsulating the reasons why she doesn't want this to happen, the consequences of it happening, it all is so beautifully crafted as a script that it just spoke to me immediately. And I just love Shirley's writing. I've worked with Shirley in another capacity, and I've been very lucky to just experience her writing. She's a lovely writer.
Tlayani?
With me, it's so ironic because I was in a taxi the time I read the script for the very first time. It was not even like the full one, it was like just like certain pieces and everything. It was cool for me, it was mind-blowing because of the fact that I was playing a part that's nothing like me. So it's so cool, like, knowing that you're gonna be playing a part that's out of your comfort zone in a way. So that's how I kind of like fell in love with it. Because I only read the script when I got to Cape Town the second day I was in Cape Town. Yeah, I read the script for the very first time, the whole thing, and it was cool. It was such like a cool script to me, and I fell in love with it then.
So Roberta Durant was your director, and she obviously took the script and brought it to life. Yes. What was it like working with her?
Well, Fanny, you can take that one first.
Okay. Roberta's she's very amazing, firstly, as a person and as a director. She's so cool. She gives you that time to actually think about, like, your role and everything. She doesn't just, you know, she's the type of person to, like, let you improvise on your own, like, words and everything. You don't have to, like, follow the script exactly the way it is. As long as it's, like, you comfortable with the words you're saying and the way you express that emotion is cool. Yeah, it's cool with her. So I think she's very amazing, firstly, as a person and as a director, and yeah, she's cool.
Linda?
Well, I've actually been very lucky to work with Roberta on a different capacity. I've done a couple of drama series for her production house, Penguin Films. So, you know, over the years, I've gotten to know her. And then working with her intimately as a director was yet another way of discovering Roberta. She's truly a lovely woman. She is so... she's so precise with how she carries out her work, and I really respect that because she has a very good, strong idea of what it is that she's looking for. And that gives you the strength as a performer to know that you are being steered in the right direction for the finished product, because she's got the overview, and you are coming in there with your very subjective opinion as the performer, as that actor character. And she steers you beautifully into that direction. And as you can see, for the movie itself, it just gets beautifully crafted.
And then, of course, Dame Janet Suzman. That must have been an experience. Oh. Tell me about it.
People think that because she's old, it's like she's the, like, okay, not very old, but like old. People think that she's the type to just, like, you know, come in to set, do the part, and just leave. She's so cool. Like, we had this conversation inside, like, she was telling me about these books. I don't read I read a lot, but, like, not these, like, you know, I read books which, like, fiction and all that. I don't read, like, these realistic books. She was just telling me about this book. It was so cool. We had, like, these fun conversations. We ate chocolate together and everything. She's very cool. She's not, like, the typical old granny type. She's an amazing person. She's a great actor too, actress too. I never knew why she was nominated for, like, the Oscar, but I saw why now. She's very good. Like, she's good. She's very good.
Linda, what was it like for you working with kids in this film?
Well, yeah, it was a first being a mother of three as opposed to one or two from zero. No, but it was great. I think that, you know, be it Owe to be it, Elvis, be it Layani, each and every one of them was just so amazing. The beauty of a kid is that, you know, you put them into a scenario and for real they feel those emotions coming through. They are just so present within each and every one of those scenes. I mean, my heart was breaking as I was shouting at him because I felt like, no, it's not real. But I mean, like, he's just so amazing at what he does. Same as Owe to and Elvis. They're full of life. I mean, sugar rushes and all sorts. But it was great fun.
Where was the film shot and how did you guys work around your schedules? Because obviously you've got school and you've got things like that. So how did it all kind of fit together to end up with this awesome finished product?
Well, I actually took some time off the daily drama shoot every other day. So I had a month off and we went down to Cape Town and I was able to do my bit within that month. But for Tlayani, I think it was a little different.
Yeah, for me, like, I had to go to Cape Town, obviously, because I don't live here. I don't live in Cape Town. So I was actually happy at the fact that I was going to be missing school. I don't really like school or anything. But when I got down there, we had a tutor. It was like, oh, okay. But then we got a tutor and, like, she came in, like, from day to day to just come and, like, you know, have little lessons with me and everything. And yeah, that was the time we managed. We shot scenes and, like, my favorite scene was the sand dunes one. It was so cool. It was like over the ocean and everything. So it was like a beautiful place. But yeah, that's where we, yeah.
All about time management. Yes. Thank you so much for joining us. We are out of time. Thank you. It's been really great to chat to you. Lindos Okulu and Tlayani Mabasa, Fundy Film, Felix.